Okay, students, in today's lecture, we have a practical session on control statements. Clear? Okay, we have already learned what is control statement. Actually, these are the statements that are used for implement logical checks, conditions, clear? And these are called so because they actually control the execution of flow. Okay, they are controlling the execution flow of the program, as we see in the theory lecture. So we have three types of control statements, like conditional statements, looping, and jumping. And in theory lecture, we have learned about these all statements. Okay, in conditional, we have if else, if and else switch statements. Clear? These are called conditional because they are used for checking conditions, logical tests. Clear? And if the condition is true, then we have to execute some statements, or if the condition is false, then we have to execute another statements. Clear? We are changing the flow of the execution. Clear? Second are the looping statements, and these are used when you are interested for performing or repeating some actions for a number of times. Okay, so in this case we have these four type of looping statements, and last is jumping statements, in which we when we are interested for stopping a loop in between. Okay, or we have to skip some iterations in a loop. Okay, or we have to jump in some portion of a program. Okay, for these type of we will use jumping statements. Okay, break statements will move the control out of the loop, or if we are using in the switch, then it will move the control out of the switch. Clear? Continue statement is used for skipping some iterations in the loop. Clear? Like we have to print 1 to 10 numbers. Clear? But if there is a 5, then we have to skip this 5th iteration, and we will continue to 6. Okay, we have execute 1 to 4 iterations, and from 4th we will directly move to 6. We have skipped 5th iteration. Okay, like these type of applications we are using continue statement. Okay, we will see in the example. Clear? Okay, this is the syntax of conditional statement. First, simple if statement. We will see the example, and now I am sharing the screen with you. Okay, we have is the screen is visible to you? Everyone is able to see the screen? Okay. In this example, we are going to see the example of if statement. Okay. For this, we have a variable x and having value 20. Okay. Okay, we rename it as age, and here we are checking if variable age is less than or equal to 37. Okay, then we will print echo कैंडिडेट इज एलिजिबल. ओके एंड सिंपल इफ इज यूज वेयर यू हैव ओनली वन डिसीजन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ कंडीशन. ओके इफ यू हैव ओनली वन डिसीजन लाइक इफ कंडीशन इज ट्रू देन वी विल परफॉर्म सम एक्शंस एंड इफ कंडीशन इज फॉल्स देयर इज नथिंग. क्लियर. नाउ वी हैव टू सेव दिस फाइल. सेव एज इफ डेमो ओके डॉट पी एच पी ऑल फाइल्स सेव. ओके आई हैव सेव्ड दिस फाइल विद इफ डेमो डॉट पी एच पी. नाउ इन द ब्राउजर राइट लोकल होस्ट एंड द फोल्डर विच यू हैव ऑलरेडी क्रिएटेड इन द एच डी डॉक्स फोल्डर एज वी डिड इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स. क्लियर. Now this is our file if demo. Click on it. Okay, this will run. Candidate is eligible. Okay, we can see the code here. Now age variable have 20. Okay, and we are checking in if age less than or equal to 37. Now age have 20 value, so condition is true. Control enters in the if block and execute this. Clear. Okay, now if we have 40. In age, then execute this statement. Then there is nothing to print. Clear. Now age have 40 value and 37 and 40 less than or equal to 37. Condition is false. So condition is false. So if will not run and control will does not enter, control does not enter in the if block and simple program closed. Clear. Okay, this is the simple if statement. Now okay, now we have if else statement. Okay, this statement is used when you have two decisions. Okay, when you have two decisions on the basis of a condition, if a condition is true, then you have to perform some action. And if condition is false, then you have to perform some another action. Clear? Like if condition is true, then control will enter in the if block and execute this and just move to next statements. But if condition is false, then control will move to else block and execute else block. Clear? We will see in this example. Now this is I am going to write example of if else statement. Okay, if else statement. Now this is a if and we are writing here else print echo candidate is not eligible. Okay, save this file with if else demo dot ph. Save. Clear. If we have 20 in the age, okay. Now we have the file named as if else demo. It prints candidate is eligible because age is 20 and 20 is less than or equal to 37. Condition is true. So control enters in the if block and print this line. Clear. Now if we have a 40. In the age variable, okay, see now it prints age candidate is not eligible. Okay, if is false because 40 is greater than 37, so if is false and control transfer to else block. Clear. And it executes the else block. Clear. Okay, this is the example of if else statement. Now we have if else statement. Clear? This statement is used when you have multiple choices, clear, and you have to execute one of them. Clear? You have a multiple conditions or you have multiple choices and you want to execute only one from them, clear, then you can use if else statement, or you can use switch statement. We will do after this. Okay, in this case, how if else statement executes? First condition is defined with if, and second, or after this, all the conditions are defined with else if, clear, and at the last we have else. We can define any number of conditions, clear. First condition is defined with the if statement, and rest conditions are defined with the else if statement. Clear? Now, if condition is true, then it will execute this statement and exit from the if else statement. Clear? If first condition is false, then control will move to the next else if condition. And if second condition is false, then it will move to the third else if statement. And if third else if statement false, it will move to the next else if statement. Okay. If all the conditions are false, then it executes else block. Okay. Clear? Now we have the example of if else if statement. Like here we are having two variables and we are having here three options, and in the option variable we have selected the third option. Okay, third option is selected, and now third condition will execute. Okay, we will see the example by implementing it. Okay, now we will do the example of if else statement. Clear? Here we have a variable 1 and we have variable 2, 30 value, and one variable is option. Okay, we will assign value to option 2. Now we have echo statements 1, 4, addition. We have a line break. Echo 2, 4, subtraction. Echo statement 3, 4, multiplication. Okay. Clear? Now we are printing here selected option is option variable. Printing next line. Clear? Now in the we have if option equal to 1. Okay, then we will print addition is, okay, variable 1 plus variable 2. Clear? Now we have else if else if option equal to 2, then we will print multiplication is subtraction, sorry. In second case, we have a subtraction. Subtraction is clear. In third case, else if multiplication is. Okay. And in if any no condition is true, then it will print option does not match. Clear? Save as if else if demo dot php all files. Save. Clear? Okay. We have two variables. Then we have a third variable for option. These are the options 1, 2, and 3. And where option is matched, that condition will be executed. Okay. Then control move outs from the if, else statement. Clear? We have saved this file with if else if demo.php. Now we will run this file. We have named it if else if demo.php. Okay, here is the error. Okay. Okay, I will put the curly brackets. Clear? Save this file and run this file. Clear? Here you can see 1 for addition, 2 for subtraction, and 3 for multiplication, and selected option is, okay, we will print option variable. Here we are printing option variable, and option variable have 2. Okay, now in the if statement, it will check option equal to 1, but option have 2. So this will not execute, it will check next condition. Here it check option equal to 2, here match is found. This condition is true, and control enters in this if else if statement and execute this. Okay, and so it will perform subtraction, then exit from this if else statement. Okay, now if we have 3 in the option, then see. Then see here, now it first check option here, does not match, then next does not match, because option now have 3. Checking here, here is match found, and it will print this else if true. So it execute this statement. Clear? Multiplication is okay. Now if we have 5 in the option variable, then run, see, it will first check option variable here, does not match, then on next else if does not match, then on next else if does not match, all the if else if conditions are not true, so at the last it will execute else block, and it will print option does not match. Clear? Okay, now we have Now we have switch statement example. Okay. Closing the body tag and closing the HTML tag. Clear? Switch statement example. Clear? We will do the same example as we did in the if else statement. Okay, we having same variable 1 equal 40, variable 2 equal 30, and our option variable having value first we 1. Okay, now we have same statements. Okay, 1 for addition, 2 for subtraction, and 3 for multiplication, and selected value is okay. Now we have switch keyword. You have to pass it variable, okay, which you want to compare, like we are comparing option. Okay, and in the body of switch you have to define its body by using curly brackets, opening and closing. Now for defining condition we have a keyword case, like in this you will see we have first condition by using if, here we are using case. Okay, now here is the value with which you want to compare, like 1, we are comparing with 1. Okay, so write here 1. Okay, so write here 1. Clear? In this we are printing addition is. Clear? So we will write here addition is. Now here we will use a break statement, a jumping statement, which will move the cursor, move the control out of switch. Clear? I will show you the purpose of break statement here. Now second value is 2, like this, here you can see. Okay, second value is 2. In second we are printing subtraction is, then we will use break statement. Clear? Now case value 3, we are comparing with 3, so we will write here 3. Okay, multiplication, and we will use break statement. Okay, at the last, if no case will execute, we have default block. Like in this we have else block, in this we have default block, if no case will execute. Clear? Save this file, save as all files in C drive, XAMPP folder, htdocs, PHP script. Here we will write switch demo.php. Okay, you can see the difference. Clear? In same program, in the if else, if and else statement. Okay, here you have to pass the variable to which you want to compare, like here we are writing. Clear? And this is the values with which you want to compare. Okay, it is not mandatory, here always 1 will come. Okay, here value you write. Okay, value with which you want to compare, it may be 2, 3, 4, 5, any value. Clear? Okay, now we will execute this program, switch demo. Switch demo. You can see it prints 70. Okay, addition. Now if option variable have 2. Okay, now it will print 10. Subtraction. Clear? Okay, option variable have two value. We are passing it to switch, and option variable is compared with this. 2 is equal to 1? No. It will move to next case. 2 is equal to 2? Yes. It will perform this. It will execute second case. Clear? After printing this statement, break statement will move the cursor out of the switch. Clear? If we are not using break here, clear? Then what will happen? Let's see. Option variable have two value. Okay. Now see the output. Okay. We are not using any break statement with. I will put break statement, then line break, then you will more understand what happening. Okay. Option variable have two value. Clear? First it check with this one not match, then it move to next case. Here match is found. Then it will print the subtraction. Okay. There is no break statement, so it automatically execute all these statements in the switch. Okay. Then after the comparison is found, after the match is found, then it treats all the rest cases as normal statements. Clear? Because it need only one comparison to be true. Okay. Then after match found, it will take other statements as normal statements. Then it executes all the statements. Okay. Until break is found. Clear? Or if break is not present, then it execute all the next statements. So suppose here we have a break statement in after case 3. In case 3, we have a break statement. Then see what happened. Okay, now see. It executes second case, then no break, then it will execute third case. Okay. After this, it have a break. So break move the control out of the switch. Clear? So we have to use break statement here so that no other case should execute. Okay. Only that case will execute. Only that case should execute where match found. Clear? Now, if suppose we have 4, 5 here in the option variable, we have 5. Now see the output. See the output. Option F 5. Okay. It will check with 1, no match. With 2, 2 equal to 5, no. 3 equal to 5, no. No case found true. Then at the last, it execute default block. Okay. If default block is present, then it will execute default block, default statement. That is option does not match. If default block is not there, then it simply close the program or simply jump to the next statement. Clear? Then it will show nothing. Okay. If default block is there, then if no condition is found true, no case found true, then it will execute the default statement. Clear? Okay, this is all about the conditional statements. Okay, now we have looping statements as we did in the last theory lecture. Looping statements are used to for performing, or if you want to repeat some actions for a number of time, okay, then you will use the concept of loop. In this, we have four types of loops: while, do while, for, and for each. For each loop, we will do when we cover the topic of array. Because for each loop, is used with the array. Okay, so first we have a while. While, as I already said, if you are working with loops, then there is a three components of loop. First is starting point, condition, and ending point. Okay, ending point. These are three. Like here we have initialized variable like loop counter. Here we have a condition, and here we have increment. Okay, ending point is to which you want to execute the loop. Okay, like we are interested in printing 1 to 10 numbers. So in this case, 1 is your initial starting point and 10 is your ending point. It also a stopping condition. When we reach at 10, we will stop the loop. Okay, how we will reach towards your ending point? By using increment, okay, or decrement. Clear? And loop will execute while your condition is true. Okay, after executing the loop, it will check the condition. First it check the condition. If condition is true, then your control will enter in the loop, and after executing the loop, it will again check the condition. Okay, if condition is true, then it will again execute the loop. This process continue until the condition is found true, false. Okay, let's see the example of looping statement. Okay, suppose we have x equal 1 and we are printing first natural numbers, first 10 natural numbers. Clear? For this we have while x less than equal 10. Clear? Here we are printing echo x. Here we are using line break, and here we will print x. Okay, we will increment x, because first x is 1, then after, okay, then x will increment 2, 3, 4, 5. Save as all files, while demo, replace the file. Okay, now we will execute while demo file, while demo.php. okay, you can see here we have initialized x, we have starting point. Clear? Starting point 1 and ending point is 10. Clear? Here we have a condition, if x less than or equal to 10. Okay, in first iteration, x equal 1, 1 less than equal 10. Condition is true. So control will enter in the while block and print value of x 1. Okay, then it increment x equal x plus 1. Clear? Now x have value 2, then again it check the condition, 2 less than equal 10. Condition is true. Again enter the loop and print value of x 2. Then again it increment x. Now x have 3, then again check the condition, 3 less than or equal to 10. Condition is true. Okay, control enter in the loop and print 3. Similarly, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. After printing 10, it will increment x. Now x have 11. Okay, now x have 11. So 11 less 11. ओके 11 11 लेस देन इक्वल 10 कंडीशन इज फॉल्स ओके कंट्रोल विल एग्जिट फ्रॉम द लूप क्लियर ओके इन व्हाइल फर्स्ट कंडीशन इज चेकड इफ कंडीशन इज ट्रू देन कंट्रोल विल एंटर इन द लूप otherwise control simple exit from the loop okay this is the example of while loop okay this is the example of while loop now we will do the example of do while okay if x suppose we have in x we have a 0 we will take any example and we are checking x while x is greater than 0 clear okay here we have a do while same code we are printing the value of x okay and we have same condition in do while here we are printing do while here we are printing while echo clear we are using in this we are also using while loop okay here we are using while loop and here we are using do while okay first listen about the do while in do while do means just do just perform clear in case of do while first body of loop will execute okay after execution of body of loop then condition is checked clear first body of loop will execute then after condition is checked and if condition found true then control will again execute the loop okay after executing then again condition is checked and if condition is true then control again enters in the loop okay this process will continue while condition is true if condition is false then control will just exit from the do while but in case of while first condition is checked okay first condition is checked if condition is found true then control enters in the while okay if condition is false then control simple exit from the while loop but in case of do while first body of loop will be execute then after condition is checked okay clear in case of do while the body of loop will execute at least once okay after that condition is checked okay do while is used where you want to execute your body of loop at least once now let's see the difference between the while and do while okay execute this you can see x have value 0 and we are printing while it will print while here okay now condition is checked x greater than 0 x have 0 0 greater than 0 condition false so control does not enter in the while loop okay then control exit from while and control does not enter in the while because 0 greater than 0 condition is false clear now it just jump to next statement here we are printing do while and now control enters in the do while and execute this okay x 0 after executing it will check the condition now condition is false 0 greater than 0 false clear then control exit from this and program will be closed. Clear? Because condition is false. Okay. Now clear the difference between while and do while. Is it clear to you? Is it clear to you? Difference between while and do while. In case of while, first condition is checked, then control will enter in the loop if condition is true. Okay. But if condition is false, then control does not enter in the loop. But in case of do while, first the body of loop will execute, then after condition is checked. Clear? If condition is true, then control will again enter in the loop. Okay. But if condition is false, control will just go to the next statement. Clear? Okay. Now this is the while and do while statements. Now we have a for loop. Clear? As I said you, in case of loop, we will have three components. First is initialized. Initialization means your starting point of variable. Clear? Then we have a condition. Okay. Then condition, and then we have a increment or decrement part. Clear? In case of while, we have initialized here, condition is here, and we have to increment in the loop. Clear? But in case of for loop, all these components are in one line. Clear? Okay, now we will do the example of for loop. Clear? In this, take a variable like x. Okay. You can write here, or you can just write in the loop like for x equal to 1, x less than or equal to 10, and here we are incrementing x. Clear? And in this statement we are printing the value of x. Save this file, save as for demo.php. Okay. Now run this file for demo.php. Clear? You can also see the source code of this page. Okay, you can see the body of page like this. Clear? There is no any PHP code. This is the plain HTML file. This is a processed. This is the processed PHP file. Okay. After processing PHP file, it is converted into simple plain HTML file. Okay. You can see here. You can also see our code. This is the output file. This is the plain HTML file. Okay. Clear? Okay. Now, how a for loop execute? First, it will initialize the X. Then after, it will check the condition. Now, if condition is true, then control enters in the for loop and execute this. Okay. After execution, it will increment the value of x. Now x is 2. Then again, it check the condition. 2 is less than equal 10. Condition is true. Then again, it enters in the body of loop. Clear? After execution, the body of loop, it will then again increment. After incrementing, it will again check condition. And if condition is true, then it will again execute the body of loop. Okay, this process will continue until the condition is true. Clear? Like after printing the value of x 10, after printing the value of x 10, it will increment x by 1. Now x is 11. Clear? 11 less than or equal 10. Condition is false. So it will exit from the loop. Clear? Exits from the loop. Okay. One more example of for loop. Suppose we want to print the multiplication table of 5, like in this format. Okay, 5 into 2 equal 10, 5 into 3 equal 15, like this, up to 10 times. Clear? Okay, now we have to loop from 1 to 10. This is the loop 1 to 10. Okay, in this we have to write the format of printing. Clear? In echo statement. Okay, suppose here we have a variable n which is having value 5. Clear? Now see, here is the 5, 5, 5. Okay, means here we will write n. Now we have a multiplication sign. Okay. Now see, this is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Means we have x. X first. In first iteration, x is 1. In second, x is incremented and 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Means here we have a variable x. Clear? Concatenate with. Now see, here we have a equal symbol. Equal. Okay, here we will put equal symbol, concatenate with, and see on the right side of equal, we have a product of these. Okay, this we have product of these 5 into 3, 15 means we have a product of n and x. Clear? Right here, n into x. Okay, here we have a line break. Clear? Now erase this. Save this file and run this. Okay, you can see here. This is the n number 5. Now we have multiplication sign. Here we have right. Now this is the x 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Here is the equal symbol and here is the product. Clear? This is how we can print the multiplication table of any number. Okay. Okay. Is it clear to you? Okay. This is all about the looping statements. Now we have jumping statement, and in jumping statement we first have break statement. Okay, break statement. Break statement, what does it transfer the control from the loop? Clear? Or we can say it makes the control out of the loop. Clear? It is used in the loop where you want not to execute all the iterations. Clear? Like in this, we are having 10 iterations. Okay, 1 to 10. We are execute loop from 1 to 10. But if you want to execute only first 5 iterations, clear? And rest 5 are skipped. Okay, in that case, we will use break statement. Like we have seen the example of switch statement. We are not interested in executing all the cases. We are interested to execute only that case which is true. Clear? For this purpose, we have used the break statement. Clear? Suppose if we are executing only 5 iterations. Clear? If x equal 6, clear? Then what? Break. Here we are print having a printing statement, echo statement, where we are printing the value of x. Okay. Clear? Now save as this file with the break demo.php. Okay. Now run this file break demo.php. Now see, we have loop till 10, but it will only print 5. Okay. For on first iteration, x having value 1, it okay, 1 less than equal 10 condition is true, then it will enter in the loop and check if x equal 6, x having 1, so x is not equal 6, if will not execute, then it will just print value 1. After printing, it will increment x by 1. Now x have 2, 2 less than equal 10 condition is true, then it enters in the if for loop and check if x equals 6. Now x is 2, 2 equals 6, not, if is false, so if will not execute, it will print this line. Okay, after printing 2, 3, 4, and 5, after printing value 5, it will increment x. Now x have 6, 6 less than or equal 10 condition is true, enters in the for loop. Now here is the if. It check if x equals 6, x having value 6, 6 equals 6, condition is true, control enters in the if block, and here is a break. And what break do? Break move the control out of the loop, clear? And rest iterations are skipped, clear? Break statement move the cursor out of the loop, clear? Okay, now we will do the example of continue statement. Continue statement, clear? Continue, working of continue is just reverse of break statement. Okay, this is the example of continue statement. Save as continue demo dot php. Okay, what continue does? Continue will move the cursor to the starting of loop, clear? This statement is used to skip some iterations, like in this example we are skipping 6 iterations, clear? Okay, I will execute first, then we will see the output. Continue demo.php. You can see here, first x is 1 less than equal 10, and control enters in the for loop. It check if 1 equals 6, not, condition is false, so it will print just value of x. Okay, now increment x. Now x have value 2, okay? Okay, x have value 2, 2 less than or equal 10 condition is true, then enters in the for loop, then it check if x equals 6. Now x is 2, 2 does not equal 6, so if will not execute, and it will print this. Okay, after printing 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, after printing 5, x is incremented, and now x is 6, Now it check 6 less than or equal 10. Okay, condition is true. It enters in the for loop. Now it check here if x equals 6. Now x is 6. So condition is true. Condition is true. Control enters in the if statement and here is the continue statement. And what continue does? What continue does? Continue transfer the control here. Okay. We have skipped the 6th iteration. Clear? And x is incremented to 7. Now it checks 7 less than or equal 10. Condition is true. Then again enters in the for loop and check if x equals 6. No, x having value 7. So if we will not execute, then it will print 7. Clear? Then 8, 9 and 10. Okay? Clear? In this way, you can also, like we are skipping first iteration and we are skipping last iteration, okay? If x equal 1 or x equal 10, then continue, okay? We will save this and run this file. Okay, there is an error message, okay. You can see here, we have skipped the first and last iteration. It will print x equal 2. Okay, now x is 1, 1 less than or equal 10 condition is true, enters in the for loop, and here in if it check if x equal 1 or x equal 10, clear? Now x is equal 1, it returns true, it returns false, true or false will return true, so condition is true, okay? Then control enters in the if block and continue statement what does it shift the control to starting of loop. Clear? Now x is incremented to 2. Okay, after printing 9 it increment 10. 10 less than or equal 10 condition is true. Less than condition wrong, but equal condition is true. Clear? Okay, now it enters in the for loop. Now here it check if x equal to 1. This will return false because x having value 10. This returns true because x equal to true. Now false true. Now false or true. It returns true. Now if is true, control enter in the if statement and continue will move the cursor to the starting of loop. Clear? Now x having incremented by 1. Now x is 11 less than or equal to 10, condition is false, control will exit from the for loop. Clear? Okay, this is all about the break and continue statement. Now we have last statement, go to statement. Okay, go to statement. Okay, for go to statement, like we have variable we have n equal 5. We are printing multiplication table by using go to statement. Okay, here we are defining a label named t. As you see syntax of go to statement, go to keyword, then label. Okay, go to keyword and then label. Like here, label, you can give it name. Okay, we are defining it as table. Clear? We have given it name as table. In this we are printing, first we having n. Okay, here we have to give another variable, like I variable equal 1, and now we have multiplication symbol, then we have I variable, okay, then we have equal symbol, and on this we have product, okay, n into I. Clear? Now we have line break. Clear? Okay, now we are incrementing I variable here. Clear? Okay, now we are checking if variable I less than equal 10. Clear? Go to table. This is the name of the label. Okay, save this file, save as, go to demo.php. Okay, now see, go to demo.php. Okay. Now what happening? Go to statement is used to jump either in forward direction or in backward direction. Okay. If the label is defined before the go to statement, then this is a backward jump. If label is defined after the go to statement, then it is a forward jump. Clear? But in this case, this is a backward jump. Clear? Table is defined before the go to statement. Clear? Now in this we have variable n equal 5. We are printing the table of 5 and I is 1 for just conditions, or you can say because we need this 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, for this we use another variable I. Clear? Now first time these variables are created and this statement is printed. Clear? First time this statement is printed and I is incremented to 2. Clear? Now it check if 2 less than equal 10 condition is true, then control enters in the if and go to table, and here table is defined and it will print this. Okay, n is 5, this is the multiplication symbol, I is 2, equal symbol, and n into 2, 5 into 2 means 10. Clear? And now I is incremented, now I have value 3. And again it check if I less than equal 10, 3 is less than or equal to 10, condition is true, then go to label table. Clear? Again it print this statement. Okay, this jumping continue, okay, until I becomes 11. Clear? Until I becomes 11. Clear? When I becomes 11, condition is false. Clear? Okay, this is the go to statement. Okay, students, thank you for watching. We will meet in the next lecture.